Hello everyone, welcome back to Luminous Guide. I really appreciate you all waiting for such a long time. It was a pretty packed schedule, to be honest. But the good thing is that I have been doing a lot of personal readings, and the entire clan of personal readings grew so fast. That was amazing. So I thought it's high time now I start growing the brand as well, because the entire YouTube channel has taken a back seat, and that was mainly because of the editing issues. I suck at editing, and a lot, and then you know you have to end up paying a lot to an editor. So I said, you know, just leave it. This procrastination doesn't really help. I have the phone. Let me just go ahead and you know, take a video on the phone and upload it just the way I can, the way I feel, because at the end of the day I have my tools here, which are my cards. They are the ones that have really helped me bring out the best in me the entire 2020, and now starting with 2021. So these cards have been amazing tool of inspiration. This has been the purpose of my life, to go back and help and give back whatever I can through my readings. So just to backtrack, Luminous Guide is all about, if in terms of tarot, it's all about intuitive tarot reading, where we pick up energies and we you know, work with energies and give you messages and guidance accordingly. Apart from that, I'm also an NLP trainer and a counselor, so I try my best to help anyone and everyone I can through the best counseling that I and or the best guidance that I can. That's my purpose, and I'm so glad to be a part of this purpose where I can give back to humanity and universe. So this will be a quick, I do not know how long this is going to take, but this will be a reading which I'm starting right now. This is a general reading for the star sign, which is Aries. So I'm going to do a lot of star signs now. I will do general tarot reading for all the star signs in terms of career, health, relationship, whatever messages that I get. So this is specifically for Aries. If you have Aries in your chart, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, cross watchers are welcome. You can also twist the energies, male, female, does not matter. There's no gender specification here, right? So first of all, thank you again for tuning in to Luminous Guide. I really appreciate. So I'm going to use the tarot card right now to pick up an overall energy for my Aries friends. Okay, how have you been, my Aries friends? I hope you're doing well and rocking as usual. Aries is such an amazing sign. It's a fire sign, right? It brings out the best. It brings out that fiery energy whenever you meet somebody who's an Aries person. So, all right. First of all, let me tell you, all these cards are pre-shuffled, pre-meditated. However, sometimes I just don't feel satisfied enough and I need to shuffle them right in front of you. So I'll do that. Okay. Wow, the first card that I see is Queen of Cups. So your overall energy at this point in time, or for the rest of the February month, would be of love, emotions, inspiration, staying, you know, having your cups filled, staying grounded, being the queen of emotions, being the queen of love, feeling loved. So that kind of very mushy energy, it's a possibility that you may be in at this point in time. All right, if we need to clarify any cards, we are definitely going to go and do that. All right. Okay, so my Aries friends, you are going away from your fire energy and you are getting into a very emotional feeling. Maybe we've just passed Valentine, so that's the kind of feeling that you're still living by. It's a possibility. Maybe a lot of you had friends who got married or got proposed to, and you're feeling that emotion that, you know, you are now ready to start the next level. Maybe Maybe you feel that you're ready to start dating. You want to go and have a healthy dating relationship. That could be a possibility. That's the kind of energy that I'm picking up right now for you guys. But Queen of Cups, to start off a reading with Queen of Cups is such a beautiful energy, right? So congratulations on that energy. Also, it's a possibility that the sign that you're dealing with could be a water sign, all right? So that could also be a possibility, yeah? Okay, let's check what is happening in terms of career. Okay, let's pull out career card for you. Okay, I'm going to just say this. We have, the pentacles rising upon you, right? Seven of pentacles, okay? That means in terms of career, for a lot of you right now who are already in a job, maybe you have worked hard, you have manifested your pentacles, now you're just waiting for a good result. Yeah, you're waiting for that promotion, that breakthrough, you're waiting for that job opportunity that you were always looking at. You're waiting to move from one job to the other where you have given your interviews. You're waiting for a good breakthrough. So you've worked really hard on that project or that kind of, your team. Or maybe you've worked really hard on bringing a client on board. It's a possibility. And now you're waiting for the outcome. You're waiting for the result. That is what is happening in terms of career for you guys at this point in time. Okay. Let's talk about relationship. Since you're feeling all mushy and want to be loved and feel loved, let's talk about relationships. Yeah. All right. Look at this. Okay, I don't mean to laugh, but you are ready for a new beginning, my friends. You are going to start from ground zero. Do you see this number? Do you see the Fool card? What is the Fool card talking about? It's talking about just care F, it's talking about moving on. I don't care what's happening. I'm just going to go on, right? So in relationship, a lot of you are looking for a new beginning. You are just looking to move on. Even if somebody is trying to tell you that, okay, maybe this is not the right path you're taking, you don't care at this point in time. You want to venture. You want to go to that road which you have never gone before. You want to go ahead and, test your emotions. You are feeling all Queen of Cups at this point in time. You want to test your emotions. You want to see if this is the right road I'm hitting emotion wise, relationship wise. You want to see if I'm making a better decision. You just want to move on. So there is a new beginning. Either a new beginning has already started for some of you. Some of you have already got into a new relationship, and then you're going to I'm going to leave it to the universe. I'm going to go with the flow and see how it works. Or some of you are about to venture into a new beginning. So that is what it is talking about in terms of the relationship. Or some of you are also receiving new love and new relationship in your life. That can also be possible. So it's two, right? Either you are going to venture in or somebody is going to come and woo you out. So that's a possibility. Wow, this is such an amazing reading. I'm shuffling right in front of you. And at the bottom of the deck, King of Pentacles. This is your man. Your man has the money. Look at this. This is King of Pentacles right at the bottom of the deck. You are looking for something solid, something with pentacles. You need that king with pentacles, my friend. And see, look at this chariot. You have something coming your way. You have that king with pentacles coming your way. Beautiful. Beautiful. Amazing. Don't you like these very nostalgic, suspicious readings? What's going to happen next kind of situation? Yeah? Okay. Let's cool off here. I love this oracle deck that I work with, okay? So these are my angels. guiding us, guiding you, guiding me. So I would request you to ask a question, whatever question that you need to ask. The answer would either be a yes, no, or you may receive a possible advice. So whatever you're interested in, the answer for your question would either be a yes, no, or an advice. Okay, I'm not building it up. This is how it's supposed to be. So, ready? Here we go. Oh, the answer is neither yes or no. It says reconsider. You know what I'm talking about. You exactly know what I'm talking about. You exactly know what you need to reconsider. You exactly know what to reconsider. You know this. Intuitively, in your heart, in your soul, in your mind, every fiber of your body is saying reconsider. I'm not saying this. These are the cards, okay? So look at this beautiful angel who's put her sword down and praying and asking you to reconsider. That's your message from the angel's deck. This is another deck that I'm going to leave you with after I give you a message. This is Keepers of the Light deck. I love, love, love this oracle deck. This is a deck that gives me profound messages from God, goddesses, saints, angels, and everyone who is here to guide us, protect us, and help us in this 3D world and take us from this 3D world to this amazing world which has spirits and souls, and it's a different realm altogether that we are born for. We are not born to be here. We are born here for a purpose. And right now, I'm fulfilling mine. All right. So the message that you have at this point in time from the Keepers of the Light Oracle deck is... Oh, it is so beautiful. This is Hindu god Krishna. Okay. And it talks about devotion. Look at this pretty picture. Look at him. He's all blue. Blue is my favorite color. And it's a possibility that you may be seeing a lot of peacocks or pictures of peacocks or even the feather of peacock that falls. Some sort of synchronicity must be happening with you. It talks about devotion. Trust your spiritual guidance. Your commitment has been recognized. You are loved unconditionally. Isn't that what you want right now? Isn't that what you want right now, to be loved unconditionally? Isn't that what you want? And this is exactly the message that Lord Krishna is talking about. He's talking about being there, devoting yourself to whatever you do. It's okay. You need to start a new beginning any which ways. You just need to go all out. And you need to venture and see if this road, this journey is right for you or not. Because your destination is already written, my friend. It's up to you to choose your destiny. It's up to you to choose your journey, right? So trust your spiritual guidance. Your commitment has been recognized. So whatever you have committed to spiritually, look at me, all tongue twisted. My Aries friends, whatever you have committed to spiritually, that has been recognized. You are loved unconditionally. And with this unconditional love, I would like to leave you be for this month. And I will get back shortly when there is a new reading aligned for you by Luminous Guide. And when the spirit tells me that I need to have a new reading for you. So all the best and have a great one.